Hey dreamers, welcome to STEAMwork Science. Here are some of my finished products. I'm Christina from National Children's Museum, and today we're in my backyard harnessing the power of the sun to make sun prints. Get excited!
For today's activity, you'll need some special sun printing paper and the kit it comes with, some flat materials like leaves, coins, or keys. And if you don't have any sun printing paper, I'll show you how to do sun printing with construction paper and plastic wrap. And of course, you'll need an extra sunny outdoor space. Let's get started. If you're using sun printing paper, your kit should come with a special plexiglass cover. Read the package to get a good idea of the directions and steps you'll need to take. Then, start by laying out your materials face down on the plexiglass. Once you're happy with how everything is laid out, pull out a piece of sun printing paper and place the blue side face down on top of your design on the plexiglass. Then turn everything face up towards the sun so that the plexiglass is on top, sandwiching your materials between it and the sun printing paper on the bottom. Expose the paper for whatever amount of time it says on the package. Mine says 2 minutes. The paper will change colors to a pale blue in the specified amount of time. Once the specified time has passed, take your sun printing paper and plexiglass sandwich to a shady spot to prevent overexposing the paper. Then remove all the materials and dunk the paper in water. Mine says soak the paper in water for 1 minute, then dry flat. Be sure to follow any additional printing and drying instructions that your sun printing paper requires. Now let's go over how to do sun printing with construction paper. Start by putting the construction paper down in a sunny spot. I used a few different colors and types of paper to see what would work. Create your designs by putting your materials directly on the paper. Once you're happy with your designs, it's time to cover your paper. If you have plexiglass, you can use that to cover your construction paper. Otherwise, cut some plastic wrap and put it over the construction paper. You'll need something to weigh down the plastic wrap. You could use small rocks or any other lightweight objects, like the triangle paperweights I used. Leave the paper in the sun for a few hours. Once you think the construction paper was adequately exposed, remove the weights and plastic wrap, then remove the materials on the paper to see what you've patiently created.
Here are some of my finished products. I think it's so cool that you can see the dark color where I put my object and the lighter color where the sun hit on my construction paper. But the question is, how and why does this happen? Well, sunshine contains what's known as UV or ultraviolet rays. And UV rays break down chemical bonds in objects like paper and fabric and other materials over time. And in this case, the UV rays from the sun broke down the colors on the paper that we used. So by shielding certain areas of the paper from the sun with our materials, so coins and flowers and leaves, the darker original color stayed while the rest of the paper got lighter. So I left my prints out for about 4 hours to produce these results, but you can play around with exposure times to see what happens. With the sun printing paper, there's a special chemical on the paper that made this process really quick and caused what looks like a reverse exposure. So you'll notice that the covered spots are lighter, they show up as white, and the uncovered spots show up darker, which is the opposite of what happened on the construction paper, as you can see. The reverse exposure is a chemical reaction between the UV rays and the chemical that's on the paper. And I use the water, so when I dunk this in the water at the end, to finalize the chemical reaction, which is why you see this reverse exposure. No matter what method you choose to use when you create your sun prints, be sure to share your results on social media and tag us so we can see your beautiful finished projects. So until then, let's remember, dreamers, STEAMwork makes the dream work, and we're all in this together. See you real soon.